The music industry today is worth around 51.5 billion US dollars. We play music countless times throughout the day, whether it's cleaning the room, finishing some math homework, or hanging out with friends.
Counterculture music. Okay. You're going to talk about counterculture music.
I'm a big fan of counterculture music.
So what's classic rock?
So to me, classic rock is Led Zeppelin and The Who and The Beatles and Jimi Hendrix and The Doors and The Stones. That's classic rock. And one of the big things that I liked growing up, the Vietnam War had just ended, so I really liked war protest songs. Some were super subtle in their protest of the Vietnam War, and some were more obvious about what their intentions were. But so reggae was good too. I didn't really find out about reggae until I went to prep school at Mercersburg. Growing up as a kid, they didn't play Bob Marley on the radio.
Wow.
But you had talked about Woodstock. Woodstock was one of the most influential concerts because at the time, the bands that played were the most popular bands of the era. And those bands all, it was smack in the middle of the Vietnam War. And so the people who attended that weren't in the Vietnam War, obviously, but they had friends who were dying, who were coming back wounded. It was terrible. So a lot of the music there was a culture and a festival, but also at the same time protesting the war, and a lot of the songs did that.
So Crosby, Stills, and Nash played their very first concert ever as a group at Woodstock, and subsequently after that performance, one of their best hits ever was a song called Woodstock.
Whoa.
I think the Grateful Dead played, but they kept getting shocks because it was raining while they were playing and on stage. They were getting shocked.
What are shocks for people who don't know what that is?
No, they were getting shocked by the electricity.
Oh.
the guitar and the microphone were shocking them because the stage was wet. Richie Havens was really good. I think one of the biggest showstoppers was 10 years after playing the song I'm Going Home. And that was kind of like what I said about the war. That was like a soldier saying, I'm coming home from the war. You could identify that song as being that. I'm coming home from the war.
There's four of these? Oh. Oh, it's Stevie Wonder. What's a Motown?
Motown?
Yeah.
Well, that was black music from the 60s. That was when Jackson 5 and Stevie Wonder and Smokey Robinson and the Miracles and Aretha Franklin and a whole slew of black artists were putting out songs.
To sum it up, counterculture music is exactly what it sounds like. Counterculture, anti-war, freedom of expression, freedom of sexuality. These are all common themes seen throughout the 60s and the 70s genre of music.